I'll never have friends like this again in my life.
I don't need tissues at this point. I got my friends' shirts to wipe my tears on. It was a great film. I loved all the time put into it, and our season was just amazing and a lot of great memories, so I'm glad I got to like relive it and rewatch that again.
I had the chills the whole entire time.
I actually wore waterproof mascara.
I definitely plan to watch this again, for sure.
It was just like the most amazing experience ever.
At least 2 thumbs up, probably go further than that. It definitely brought out a lot of emotions. I cried a little bit, but I definitely laughed a ton, so it was a lot of fun.
To Pierre, you are headed to Green Bay!
Now we're waiting for our bus to take us to the rec center. And we're basically stranded.
There are coaches, they're really mad.
Seriously. He is talking to lamers.
His hood is up, that means he means business.
I'll be there for you. Madison Haugen from Brookfield East Girls Golf, and I've been hitting it hard getting ready for golf season this fall on W7. W7 is for the girls.
For those of you that know us, you know we've got a really strong relationship with Oshkosh women's basketball and really starting to build friendships and relationships in the Oshkosh area. Coach Jeremiah from Oshkosh reached out, and we certainly reached back to him saying, hey, we'd love to do something together. Ed, do you want to talk about how this kind of came to be and really what the event is we're going to do with Oshkosh women's golf this year?
Yeah, I've had the pleasure of knowing Coach Hoffman for many years, well before he even became the coach at Oshkosh. Great gentleman, great guy. And as soon as we touched base as far as, hey, let's maybe do something with the girls golf team, he was 1,000% on board with it. We've got arranged. We're going to a couple practices. College golf starts their season a little later than high school girls golf. But we're going to a couple of practices, practice itself plus a couple meetings, and then we're going to top it off with, we will be live broadcasting the second day of their the UW Oshkosh invite. So we will have some college girls golf live on for once.
Top of the key, Leininger to the hoop, underneath, layup good, and a steal by Gauz, layup good. Germantown basketball.
Guys, it's an 18-2 Germantown run.
Wisner up ahead. Layup Germantown. Good! The lead is 13. Wiz Kid drives.
Oh! Emily Wisner!
Kick out. Rudy. Extra pass. Three. Launch.
Look at the bench.
Josie Pliska! And the bench is going nuts! Skip pass, Rudy. Look at Rudy making extra pass. Oh! Cephalu at the buzzer!
They were 24-3 last year.
Yeah.
And they're 23-4,
gonna be,
yeah.
Yeah, and they're going to be good this year. Yeah. They just ran into a buzzsaw tonight.
Here to take you the rest of the way, here's Connor Du Bois.
Three deep from Mullins. Got it.
Always loved her length and how she utilizes it. And again, has expanded as a very, very good three-point shooter.
Same spot, dial it up. Got it. Top of the key, Jordy. Well done there by Jaselczyk. Jorga drive, left baseline, right-hand runner, off the glass. Borowski. So 17 and a half left to play. DePere will trigger. Left wing, step back, three on the way. Got it! Rebound put back, Sophie Hafeman. And one opportunity coming. Ilya Mullins wide open on the right wing, buckets. Kick out, three ball, Cuss got it. Lucy Musin. Nice drop off. Warren Schneider on the weak side. Left hand lay in.
Big event. I know this is circled in red on your calendar. Is August 26th, Thornberry Creek, Bayport. And I know the Bayport coaches were really interested in us coming out and being part of that event. Do you want to talk about that event and what we can expect to see there?
Absolutely. Thanks, first of all, to Coach Jeff Johnson of Bayport. I had contacted him. Actually, I'd heard from one of his players at the beginning of the summer season that they were hosting it. And we got in touch with each other right away. He was more than accommodating, happy to have us here. He's willing to roll out the red carpet to us, which is fantastic. This is the first time he's hosted it. We're actually going to have five, at least in the preseason rankings, five of the top six teams in state there. Westosha, Middleton, Brook East, Toma. We can see the Toma girls again, and Union Grove. It's a 12-team event. Every team that's going to be there is going to be really good. Plus Thornberry Creek, that's where they played the Women's LPGA Tour event a few years ago when they had an event in Wisconsin. So spectacular location, great teams, just looking forward to a great day. Again, can't thank Coach Johnson enough for everything he's done in reaching out and working with me, working with us, so we can put this together.
Should be a great day. Planning the day up there, the 26th, up at Bayport. Of course, big thanks to Bayport. Bayport Girls Athletics has been just fantastic to us. Volleyball, basketball. We've done some softball as well, and now golf. So getting to really just get a lot of time with the Pirate Nation up there. We really enjoy that. So looking forward to that on August 26th.
Hey, we're sitting down with head coach of the DePere Redbirds, Coach Boyle. How's it going, Coach?
Going great.
3 seed going in the playoffs. I think after that, you know, that fight against Notre Dame, not going in, you know, as the underdog, if you potentially see a matchup down the road with a Germantown squad this time around. I mean, it was just everything kind of rolled the wrong way. Second game of the year down there in Kettle Moraine. And tough to beat a team twice. And I would have to say they got to look out for DePere if that rematch were to occur.
Yeah, I mean, I you know, you go through a season, second game of the year, where we're still trying to figure out where we're at as a team. And the things that we've gone through this year through a lot of adversity, some really, you know, losing players, just tough things that go mm-hmm. on in the season. The growth that we've been making these last couple weeks is where you want to be trending this time of the year. Notre Dame is the key right there. You know, we had the game in our hands, perhaps Notre Dame. They were able to finish it. But it was a clear indication that we're making the proper growth that we need to at this time of the year. And we want to keep this group a tight family as long as we can, and we know we got to win to keep that rolling. I think it's just a pure example. It doesn't matter who we're going to play. We're going to go compete, and when we do that, we can beat anybody. So we're hoping for that matchup, you know, and getting another shot at them.
Live from Sheboygan North, it is the sectional final. The winner of today's game heads to Green Bay. And if it's Germantown, they will look to defend their state championship. And on the other side, DePere, the Redbirds, looking to reach Green Bay. First of all, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
We can't touch on today's game unless we go back to November. High screen, rotate over, pass, good. What did that play in today's game?
Yeah, obviously, we've had a hashtag 105 in our tweets ever since
long.
We lost to
all
them.
All year. Shot, floater, no good, batted around, offensive rebound, put back. Now the drive, attack, shot, good. That's Borowski, who's got three layups now. Wittick, nowhere to go. Now lobs, pressuring Hillmans. Three on the way, good. Claire Bjorgi, it's been her half. Lob inside, Millman's is going to score. First bucket of the half.
We have six seniors on this team who knew we all had confidence in each other, and we just played our best game tonight. We played together. It was awesome.
Back even.
Wow.
Catch it up ahead. Wide open. And layup good. And she threw it away. And here's Millman's on a breakaway. Pass, layup good.
We played Germantown in the beginning of the year, and they beat us pretty good. They're a good team, but we really wanted this one, and we had an outstanding game today.
Three on the way. Good. Borowski. Now they get a layup on the other end. Good. Drive down the lane. Blocked by Leininger. Millman's recovers. Put back. Good. Millman's left all alone. I think KK's exhausted. Millman's buried it.
Big, big, big shot.
That's built our pressure. That's built everything that we've gotten to this game.
2:35 and counting.
And DePere, I mean, I think they just pull it out. There's no reason.
Absolutely.
2.5 minutes left. Just burn clock.
The defending state champs. Down 8-3. Millman's down 11.
That's a big shot.
That's a dagger. Millman's rebound.
Great rebound by Millman's.
And DePere can start to feel it. Germantown down 5. They need a 3. It's blocked into Millman's hands. DePere, you are headed to Green Bay. And we will have a new state champion in Division One.
Basically preparing for this game ever since we lost to them, and we knew we could beat them. We have confidence in everyone.
Past weekend, the Redbirds booked a trip to the state tournament with a win over number one seed Germantown last weekend.
Fortunately, we learned a lot from that loss. The girls have come in and they've worked hard, and you know our players have stepped up.
Senior guard Jordan Melmans is the leader on the team. She also averages 25 points per game, good for fourth in the state. She's headed to Butler University to play Division I basketball after the season.
Jordan is the best in the state. I mean, she gets after it offensively, defensively, impacts the game in so many different ways. There's no give up in her. She wants to fight. She's a winner. And that's how she prepared herself from day one.
My points will come, but I just don't care about that. I just care about winning, going into the state tournament.
Sophomore guard Claire Bjorgi had 18 points in their victory over Germantown, and the young guard shines brightest when the pressure is on.
Invited the pressure, wanted it, and to see the things that she did, passing the ball to open teammates, finding easy scores, setting teammates up for shots, handling the pressure, finding scores for herself, just showed huge growth from her, you know, for being a sophomore. She played like a senior.
A key motto for the team is DP Grit.
Give everything you got all the time and be a good teammate as well, because that's what we really look forward to in this team, and everything you got on the court, in practice and on the games.
I feel like since we're the 4 seed, we have nothing to lose. We can just go out there and play and see what happens. I feel like it's gonna be a great game, great atmosphere. I definitely have the rush. I just have chills thinking about it. I'm so excited for Friday.
Today is our best practice of the league because it's the one that's up right now, right? We gotta be locked in, bringing energy, talking, right? We're refreshed right now. Okay, we're gonna review a lot of stuff we did yesterday, but we gotta take it up a whole new notch, right? We got a great challenge in front of us on Friday, and what we do today is gonna be preparing us and helping us for that game. Right, so let's make sure we stretch, we're ready to go. Half of the battle is mental, being mentally and physically tough, okay? Other teams gotta do the same thing. So you just gotta know that we're gonna embrace that challenge, right? Make sure we get a good stretch in. Birds on three. 1, 2, 3, birds!
Smile.
Smile, yes.
Nice.
Oh, you guys look so cute. Woo! Yeah! Oh, yeah!
Journey has a D-Day. Now, some journeys have multiple D-Days. As I was thinking about this, I thought, you know, there's probably been like 5 D-Days in my life. So you may not have even had one yet in your entire life journey. You're going to. In fact, you're going to have one tomorrow, right? And what does D-Day mean, Coach? D-Day, the simple definition is day of days.
It's D-Day, ladies. It's time to react. Let's do it.
She had DP Grit 45 years ago.
You guys have your stuff. We're gonna hang. We're all gonna leave together. All right. Yep. We're gonna leave together. So grab your stuff. Get organized. We'll leave together over here. Birds on three. 1, 2, 3. Birds.
We've been sweating our whole life. Just to get this right. It's a work hard, hit hard struggle. It's a sacrifice. It's time to blow it up. Time to lock and load. Time to take the core. Time to start the show. This is our moment. This is our time. And we since we were kids, trying to make that last step and be proud of what we did. It's time to turn it up, time to rock and roll, time to take the stage, time to start the show. This is our moment, this is our time, and we is our day.
let's talk about Greater Metro Conference. August 30th, the Fairways of Woodside. We're going back there for the third year in a row for a Greater Metro meet.
Yep. Greater Metro meet. This may be the year. Brookfield Central, Coach Scrovel, Coach Wandry have dominated the Greater Metro for many years, but sadly to say, this might be the year that their domination ends, because we've already talked some about the Brookfield East girls. Obviously, they have a lot of up-and-coming talent, and Brookfield Central also graduated out their whole starting lineup from last year. So Coach Scrovel's looking to fill holes. He does have some talent. It's just how quickly he can develop it to see how well Brookfield Central can compete. There's a couple up-and-comers this year. Sussex also, while they finished second in state last year, they lost four of their five starters. They're looking to fill holes as well. Kayla Johnson's their only returning player. Kayla's playing great. She played well all summer, but filling holes behind her is going to be a little rough. DSHA might be making some noise this year.
Yes.
Kate Krieger has qualified for state 2 years in a row as an individual. She's got Addison Roach joining her as a freshman this year. Addison is the daughter of top professional in the state, David Rose. She's been top teacher many times, and she had a great summer. So a couple players at top for DSHA. Coach Pritchard's got some work to do yet at the Falls. I can say that. Not that I don't like you, Tony. You know that all the time. He coached my son for 4 years, but we've talked a little bit about some of the holes he's got to fill. Wauwatosa, Emily Gastro, is their top player.
Yep.
She played a lot over the summer. She played well, but looking to fill in those holes behind her as well. So it's probably going to be Brookfield East. I would say they would have to be the definite favorites. Brook Central and DSHA behind them probably is second, battling for second and third. But as always, we're going to see some great golf out of these girls in the Greater Metro. There's always talent there, even though it may not be the top talent in the state. There's a ton of talent there, and we're covering them six times by the time we're done this year, Gary. We'll see them a lot. We'll see all of them a lot. So we'll look forward to learning everybody's name. We'll be on a first name basis with all of them by the time we're done.
We will. So August 30th at Fairway Woods of in Sussex, Woodside. That's a Greater Metro meet. September 8th at Greenfield, our first ever visit to Greenfield. That's a Greater Metro. These are mini meets on the 8th, and then the 12th of September, Silver Spring. We've been there a couple times. And then also wrapping up our coverage this season is September 21st. That is the Greater Metro Conference Championship. That's at Nagawaki out in my neck of the woods out here on September 21st. And that'll be an all-day event for us on that day at Nag. So
give yourself a moment to take that in, because it is special. It is amazing. It's something that you don't typically see very often in your life, if you do ever again. Okay? Take it in, enjoy the moment, and just be you.
I love to dance, so give me more, more, till I can't stand it. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Rice Center for this Division I semifinal between the Kettle Moraine Lasers and the DePere Redbirds. Let's meet the Redbirds of DePere. Number 2, Jaden Shiselsik. Number 3, Kaylee Anderson. Number 4, Olivia Wall. Number 10, Allison Wettstein. Number 11, Olivia Kust. Number 20, Elena Tripp. Number 21, Lucy Musin. Number 30, Lauren Schneider. And number 31, Sophie Hafeman. Now the starting lineup for the DePere Redbirds. At guard, a 5'9 senior, number 5, McKenna Shiselsik. At guard, a 5'7 senior, number 12, Oakley Whittick. At guard, a 5'8 sophomore, number 13, Claire Bjorgi. At forward, a 5'10 senior, number 22, Avery Borowski. And at guard, a 6-foot senior, number 23, Jordan Mullins. The head coach of the Redbirds is Jeremy Boilo.
Coach, we're all set, ready to go for a tip.
Let's have a great one here. Tip controlled by DePere.
Free ball on the way. Braylon Torres. Rangard.
Wow.
And DePere able to break it again, then get it across the timeline. Now left corner, three on the way. Long, no good from Hafeman. Reload, Melmans. Behind the college line, no good. Rebound, Shiselsik. Fighting, tries to find a cutting Melmans. And they're going to say it went off Jordan's fingertips.
Rangard to the pull-up in the lane. The lead becomes 13-0.
You're going to get out, you'll get to a game. Maybe the other team goes on a run. Things are going to happen. And then what you have to do is trust your preparation, trust each other, trust yourself, trust your coaches.
Penetration off.
There, opens the scoring.
Again, good attack by Jordan.
Melmans. There we go. Can't get it to go. Oakley Whittick rebound put back. Jorgie in the trap. She gets it out of it. Deep left corner. Jay on the way. Allison Wettstein. Melmans, top of the key. Dial it up. Fans now slowly start to climb back into it. Now Torres right wing. Guarded by Shiselsik. She'll put it on the deck. Left hand scoop shot for Torres. Up and no good. Rebound Borowski. Bjorgi to Melmans, quickly up ahead. Shiselsik right side, and one opportunity coming. And it's about to get loud in here, coach. Backdoor cut, Melmans, got it.
We never back down.
Kept alive by Whittick to Melmans. She'll go inside, a little spin around right hand, up and in. And Shiselsik right back at her. On the middle of the lane, up and in.
Great job by DePere of getting themselves back in the game. A lot of positive things, I think, for the Redbirds. Back to WIA State Semifinal Division I Championship basketball here as Kettle Moraine starts the second half with the ball.
Oh. Kick out right corner, three. For Hall scoot the board, she'll flip it up ahead. Right side, Rangard trail, three, splash. Short rim, no good, rebound, Shiselsik, kick out, Whittick.
And so smart dribbles it out, gets it out of the double team, and
right-hand runner, yeah, Alvarez.
Bailey Alvarez gets on the glass. 13th turnover. Big deep three. Becca Sedenberg. It's in the game. Two threes. Great cut behind the press right there.
Just do what you do. Stay composed. Stay together. Things aren't always going to go your way.
Rangar dials it up. Deep splash.
Good cut by Alvarez right there.
Inside Grzelski. Yeah, they leave Melman's all alone. She'll get that one to go.
Sedenberg gets beat on that one right there by Borowski.
How they go inside of Grzelski. And left just hand up strong. And in.
Grace Grzelski.
When I took over the girls' program 6 years ago, these seniors were sixth graders at my school. You know, so I had a chance to know some of the personalities and work ethic they had in school. And I know when I accepted the job this spring of that 6 years ago, those girls were excited. I was excited as well to work with them through the youth. And they haven't disappointed through their journey here at the high school, winning a lot of games and having a lot of success.
I've been here grounded far too long. I'm ready to see the open wide.
I got into basketball when I was younger. My dad's a huge basketball guy, so we've been playing ever since we could walk. So okay. It's been my favorite sport since day one and been playing ever since. So
I wanna sail towards the sun.
I got into basketball, I think in second grade. My dad honestly just signed me up and I've stuck with it ever okay. since. So I love it.
I'm ready to fly. I'm ready to soar.
I started in third grade and I just played because my siblings played and kept with it because I made friends.
I started playing basketball because my older sister started playing, so okay. I was watching her growing up, and ever since then, I love the game.
I think it's time. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to fly.
The previous record holder was Brevin Pritzel, Wisconsin Badger, currently playing professionally. And, you know, both those players, him and Jordan, very similar. They come to lead, and they come to work every day and help their team to win. That's all they care about is winning, and those records kind of take care of themselves.
I decided number 23 because, well, LeBron is my favorite player, and he used to wear 23, and I was named after Michael Jordan.
win those big games, you got to have that rebounder you can depend upon, you know. And she's hit some big threes throughout this year as well.
I wear 22, and I wear that number because her mom was in charge of handing out the jerseys, and that's the number she gave me, so I just stuck with it.
Defender, can handle the ball, you know, understands how we need to play, and it does a great job of contributing that way.
I'm number 12, but I used to be number 2, and unfortunately grew out the small number 2 jersey, so I just went up to the next number 2.
She takes a ton of pride in defense. She just comes to work. She's on a mission every day. There's not a girl that takes this game as serious as she does, and she's passionate.
I wear number 5, and I used to be 32. That was my dad's number, and then my mom was 23. So I figured high school, I should represent them both. So I picked 5 to add those numbers together. So.
Loose the goose. She makes sure that in practice and games that, you know, when we're getting after it, we can smile. She can have a little fun challenge at me every once in a while.
I'm Lucy, and I wear number 21 because that's just my lucky number.
She works hard. She's got a smile on her face. She's one of those kids that understands her role, and her role is to be the best teammate she can be.
I've enjoyed watching Olivia DeClean
play
basketball, and we coincidentally have the same name, and she was number 4, so I went with number 4.
Don't take anything for granted because time goes by fast. I literally feel like we were just in like 4th grade. Give it your all no matter what, no matter what anyone says. If you want to achieve your goals, just keep working hard and you'll definitely do that.
Even if you don't want to go to practice some days, just know that you're there with your best friends and one day you're going to split up and all go to college. So,
if you have a positive attitude, then practice will just be so much better and you'll end up having so much more fun.
Stick with it. I mean, there's going to be days where you don't want to go to practice, but it'll be worth it in the end.
Basketball gave me so many great friendships. It's a great sport, and I had so many great memories on and off, so just stick with it, and you'll make memories that will last with you forever.
What did everyone get?
I got mac and cheese.
Lemonade.
I had a bowl of soup, half a sandwich, and lemonade.
I had mac and cheese, bread, and lemonade.
Oh, I had salad.
Oopsie.
Salad and a sandwich and chips. Here's our surprise that was left for us for after practice. Ooh, shamrock shakes. Yeah. Lucky shamrock shakes.
Lucky us.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that, Irish.
I love mint.
Oh, yeah. Except for someone doesn't like mint, so. Of course, she got a special request. After practice, shamrock shakes. We need all the luck we can get this week.
The other bar.
Here's
the victory, Connor.
Chelp, had some leftover cookie dough, and they made a special trip for you guys. So make sure you say thank you to the volleyball.
Thank you.
Oh, I got. We're just
the we just got cookie dough
from our volleyball team. Thank you, guys.
Yeah, we aren't gonna be able to run up the court on Friday.
T Bucks got a cookie.
We are looking at out of school. We got cookies, state house,
free lunch,
Herbert's and Gerberts.
We're going to get Chick-fil-A.
We're going to get Chick-fil-A.
Why not?
All right, here is my dog. She has grit. She's matching with you, Connor. Love it. Aww.
I love my team so much.